Hi there, I'm B. Today I want to talk about the spline component. I think this is a very interesting component that you can use to do things like animate objects, for example cameras. You can use it for example a character that you want that character to go from one point to another instead of using the nav mesh or In, for example, in Fantasy Little Jobs, the VR game that I developed last year, we used this component for the arcade mini game where we have ducks, so we use the spline component to move the ducks. I have a tutorial based on that in the description below, and also I link below the game. As you can see in this example, I have this robot with that car that goes around this spline component, and it goes in loop. So it goes with constant velocity, goes around, around, around. So this is one of the practical examples for the spline component. I basically have only one blueprint, which is this basic spline controller. And it's very basic. It has a root and the spline component. If you are used to seeing my videos, you know that I usually go for the same approach when I create the actors. In this case, is this for this example, I created this basic spline controller for that extends from actor. And I usually go for something similar because it's quite comfortable and I like. And as usual for this spline controller, I only have two components, which is the root, and as usually it's visible anywhere, blueprint read write, and I usually put this category because it makes easy to find things on the editor. And the other one is the spline component with the same properties. If we take a look at the constructor, we can check what's going on with those two components. And as usual, we have to create both subdefault objects. Here's the root, which set as a root component, it will be this root. And the spline component, which is a EU spline component. Don't forget to include the header. For the spline, we set the root, the previous root component, and we set a couple of initial variables, which is the duration of the spline, which is the length. The duration is a new property that I'll show later. This is just to show on the editor the debug. If we go back to the blueprint, based on that basic spline controller, that spline class, we can see the root and the spline, nothing else. So the spline is quite easy to use. We can add and remove points. So for example, I can take these points and modify the curve. We can change the type of point. For example, we can set linear. I like the curve. We can add, for example, over here another point, so we can modify that and make it more interesting. So there are different things that we can do with that. Here we have the duration, that's the length, and that will determine how the speed of the object that goes on the spline. It allows to change the color of the selected point, quite neat. Okay. And also the color of the spline. I like the blue one. I'm sure there are more things that we can do with this, but for this example, this is more than enough. We can delete the points, we can add points. It's very flexible, so it's quite useful. As soon as I play star, or in that, in the case of the example simulate, an actor is spawned. I set that on an U property, so I have this subclass of actor to move, which is this is the that robot that is being spawned on begin play. And I keep a reference to that actor because I'm gonna move this actor in this spline controller. This is the begin play, and as you can see, I always like to check for null reference. So this is important because sometimes in Unreal crashes, if we don't do this kind of checks and we forget to set the element on the blueprint. So I highly recommend to do this null check reference, and it's a good practice in general. And it's very simple. What I do is basically I spawn the actor with that actor to move class. I set as a transform the spline, so it will spawn on the 000 of that spline component, and I keep the reference. Again, I like to check for the null reference just in case this went wrong. And that's it. Next thing I do is I take the start time, because I'm gonna use that later on the tick to move the actor. This start time is taking the get time seconds. This will give me the seconds since you press play. So it will start in 0, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and go on. And I have this sanity boolean to indicate that we can move the actor because it's been spawned and everything is ready to be moved. If I go to the blueprint, we can see that the actor to move class is over here. This is basically a simple actor that it has nothing. It's just a simple blueprint object with the static mesh. So it's based on the actor class that Unreal provides, nothing else, and I just add this static mesh with the car and the road because I thought it was fun. But it's nothing else, it's just a simple actor that will help me to move that. We could just use another static mesh or a cube or just something simple. The movement of that robot happens on the tick, so every frame. And here's when things get interesting. So first thing first is add that null reference, null check, and also this we can move actor to make sure that we can start moving and nothing happens before everything is set. First thing we need to do is to take the current time for the spline, and this is we take again the current time based on when you press play. Oops. We subtract the start time, which will start in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so this will give us that difference. And we divide that for the total path time controller. This total path time controller is also another U property, which is defined over here. So we can edit this anywhere, and I like to do the category so it's easy to find on the blueprint. I also keep this B spline in loop so we can control it. We can keep moving the object as soon as it finishes, so it will go in loop, or we can just do one round and that's it. Those U properties appear here. So this kind of thing, I like to do this kind of things this way, adding some elements on the editor, because if a designer comes, it can change these elements and buy things. So it's a good way to have a good balance between C++ and Blueprint. First thing we need to do is to get the distance for the spline, for both the position and the rotation. And we can get that just simply getting the length of the spline for the time. So this will give us the distance in each point of the spline. Next thing is get the position, the wall position for the actor to move that robot. And we can use this handy method, which gives us exactly that, the location in wall position in a specific distance. So we just need to set the center distance and indicate the space that we want to work with. And in this case, it's wall space, so we use this. And basically, we just need to set that position in the actor, in the robot, in the car with the robot. Next thing is the rotation, which is a bit more tricky, but we also have a quite handy method for that. In this case, it will give us a direction based on a distance, and the parameters are the same: distance and the type of space for that. In this case, it's again the wall rotation. So this method over here, it will give us direction, a vector director normalized. So it will have one as a size of the vector. This is important because we need to have this vector of size one for later. So with this direction, we can create a rotator. We can use that rotator, that direction to create the rotator that we're gonna use to actor to move. In this case, we are only interested to rotate the actor in the X direction. So that's why we can use this handy function to create a matrix from the X direction. It's important to give here a vector director of size 1, so it's normalized, and just get the rotator of that, and simple as that, the object will move and rotate according with the spline. And finally, this code indicates if the object has finished the actor has finished the path. And here we can just reset everything again, so the actor will move again in the same spline or not. And for that, I have this B splining loop, which is another U property. We set this to true again, so it will go back to take this boolean and do everything again. And it's important to reset the start time and the current spline time, so everything will start again. So if we set this again, we can see the robot going across the line and on. We can play a little bit with this. We can make this faster, for example, 6 and no spline. So it will go faster. We can make it even faster. It will go super fast. And stop there because I said not in loop. And that's it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel if you consider this video useful. And also, you can like and share this video, it helps a lot. Don't forget to hit the bell button to get notifications for future videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye!